Dear students, welcome to today's pathophysiology class, stroke. So, stroke is defined by the World Health Organization as a clinical syndrome consisting of rapidly developing clinical signs of focal or global in case of coma, focal disturbance of cerebral function lasting more than 24 hours or leading to death with no apparent cause other than a vascular origin. So here no other cause, major cause is vascular origin, that means blood vessel decrease in the blood supply or some bleeding. So here only vascular origin cause is responsible for the symptoms of coma development due to cerebral function disturbance. So it may be lasting more than 24 hours, it may lead to death. So stroke is a brain disorder, nervous system disorder or cerebral disorder due to the vascular origin cause. Risk factor for stroke are nothing but the etiology of stroke. High blood pressure. High blood pressure is the main risk factor for stroke. Blood pressure is considered high if it stays at or above 140/90 millimeters of mercury over time. If you have diabetes or chronic kidney disease, high blood pressure is defined as 130/80 millimeter mercury or higher. So high blood pressure is the first cause for the occurrence of stroke. Second cause is diabetes, supporting factor. So diabetes is a disease in which the blood sugar level is high because the body doesn't make enough insulin or doesn't use it insulin properly. Insulin is a hormone that helps move blood sugar into cells where it's used for energy. So diabetic patients are susceptible to stroke easily. Then third cause is heart diseases. Coronary heart disease, cardiomyopathy, heart failure and atrial fibrillation can cause blood clots that can lead to a stroke. So heart diseases, coronary heart disease, that means blood vessels of heart, some improper may happen. So that is coronary heart disease. Cardiomyopathy in muscles, enlargement of the heart due to some improper in the muscles, heart muscles. Heart failure, left or right sided heart failure, atrial fibrillation. Then next fourth cause is smoking. Smoking can damage blood vessels and raise blood pressure. Smoking also may reduce the amount of oxygen that reaches your body's tissues. Exposure to secondhand smoke also can damage the blood vessels. So risk factor for stroke is high blood pressure, diabetes, heart diseases, smoking. So four causes we discussed. Next, age and gender. Your risk of stroke increases as you get older. So as the age increases, body risk to the stroke increases. At younger age, men are more likely than women to have strokes. Men are easy getting strokes than the women. However, women are more likely to die from strokes. Women who take birth control pills also are at slightly higher risk of stroke. Birth control pills taking women are at higher risk. Then sixth is race and ethnicity. Strokes occur more often in African American, Alaska Native and American Indian adults than in white, Hispanic or Asian American adults. So different race, African American, Native Alaska people are easily getting the stroke. Personal or family history of stroke or transient ischemic attack. If you have had a stroke, you are at higher risk for another one. Your risk of having a repeat stroke is the highest right after a stroke. A TIA means a transient ischemic attack, also increases your risk of having a stroke as does having a family history of stroke. So here transient ischemic attack means persons are suddenly getting stroke due to improper blood supply suddenly. That is called transient ischemia. Transient ischemia means sudden blood supply to the brain decreases. Transient ischemic stroke. Brain aneurysms are arteriovenous malformations. Aneurysms are balloon-like bulges in an artery that can stretch and burst. AVM, arteriovenous malformations, are tangles of faulty arteries and veins that can rupture, break open within the brain. AVMs may be present at birth, but often aren't diagnosed until they rupture. So, AVM, arteriovenous malformations, get converted into aneurysms, balloon-like bulging of the arteries, which will burst and cause the attack, that is a stroke, brain attack. Other risk factor for stroke, many of which of you can control, include alcohol and illegal drug use, including cocaine, amphetamines and other drugs. So use of alcohol, illegal use of drugs and cocaine, amphetamines should be controlled, which are causing the stroke easily. Certain medical conditions such as sickle cell disease, vasculitis, that is inflammation of blood vessels, and bleeding disorders, which are causing the stroke. Lack of physical activity, overweight and obesity, stress and depression, unhealthy cholesterol levels, unhealthy diet. So these are also causing the stroke. Then use of non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, that is NSAIDs, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, but not aspirin, may increase the risk of heart attack or stroke. Particularly in patients who have had a heart attack or cardiac bypass surgery, the risk may increase the longer non-steroid anti-inflammatory drugs are used. Common NSAIDs include ibuprofen and naproxen. So the persons who are getting the anti-inflammatory drugs such as aspirin and ibuprofen and naproxen are easily susceptible to stroke. Then classification of stroke. The two major categories of stroke are ischemic stroke, hemorrhagic stroke. Ischemic stroke, lack of blood and hence oxygen to an area of the brain. So blood supply decreases, due to that stroke happens in brain, that is called ischemic stroke. Hemorrhagic stroke, bleeding from a burst or leaking blood vessels in the brain causing the stroke. So two types of stroke, that is hemorrhagic stroke, ischemic stroke. You can see in the diagram, ischemic stroke, anoxia, thrombus is there. Hemorrhagic stroke, hemorrhage, a rupture of the blood vessel is there. And you can see in other diagram, block and bleed. So blocking ischemic stroke is caused by the blocking of blood vessels in the supply to the brain. That may be due to the embolus or thrombus. So emboli and thrombi. So ischemic stroke again classified into two strokes, embolic stroke, thrombotic stroke. Then bleeding. So due to bleeding, oxygen supply to the brain decreases. Hemorrhagic stroke, subarachnoid bleeding or intracerebral bleeding. So subarachnoid stroke, intracerebral stroke. Then next, pathogenesis of ischemic stroke. Ischemic stroke is lack of sufficient blood flow to perfuse cerebral tissue due to narrowed or blocked arteries leading to or within the brain. So lack of sufficient blood flow to the brain, cerebral region. Then ischemic strokes can be broadly subdivided into thrombotic and embolic strokes. Narrowing is commonly the result of atherosclerosis. So blood vessels narrowing due to atherosclerosis, which is also causing thrombotic and embolic strokes. The occurrence of fatty plaques lining the blood vessels is observed in the atherosclerosis. As the plaques grow in size, the blood vessels become narrowed and the blood flow to the area behind is reduced. Damaged areas of an atherosclerotic plaque can cause a blood clot to form, which blocks the blood vessel, a thrombotic stroke. So you can see here, I will repeat, damaged areas of an atherosclerotic plaque. So atherosclerotic plaque is there, can cause a blood clot to form, which blocks the blood vessel. So atherosclerotic plaque and blood clot both combinedly is there in the thrombotic stroke. Thrombus is nothing but the blood clot with atherosclerotic plaque. In an embolic stroke, a blood clots are debris from elsewhere in the body. Typically, the heart valves travel through the circulatory system and block narrower blood vessels. So here, atherosclerotic plaque is not there. Instead of atherosclerotic plaque, blockage will be observed due to narrowing of blood vessels, that is embolic stroke. Next, based on the etiology of ischemic stroke,
A more accurate subclassification of ischemic stroke is generally used. Large artery disease, small vessel disease, embolic stroke, stroke of determined etiology, stroke of undetermined etiology. So first, large artery disease, atherosclerosis of large vessels including the internal carotid artery, vertebral artery, basilar artery and other major branches of the circle of Willis. So you can see here diagram in which vertebral artery, common carotid artery, posterior cerebral artery, middle cerebral artery and anterior cerebral artery is there. So here all cerebral arteries are there. This blockage is there, means large artery disease causing the stroke. Small vessel disease, second one, changes due to chronic disease such as diabetes, hypertension, hyperlipidemia and smoking that lead decreased compliance of the arterial walls or narrowing and occlusion of the lumen of smaller vessels. Due to diabetes, hypertension, hyperlipidemia and smoking, small vessel disease occurs. Then embolic stroke. The most common cause of an embolic stroke is atrial fibrillation. Next, fourth one is stroke of determined etiology, such as inherited diseases, metabolic disorders and coagulopathies. So these are inherited diseases, metabolic disorders and coagulopathies which are cause for the stroke, that is called determined stroke. Stroke of undetermined etiology, after exclusion of all of the above, in the core area of stroke, blood flow is so drastically reduced that cells usually cannot recover and subsequently undergo cellular death. The tissue in the region borderline the infarct core, known as the ischemic penumbra, is less severely affected. This region is rendered functionally silent by reduced blood flow, but remains metabolically active. So here, stroke of undetermined etiology, other than the above mentioned causes, will cause the undetermined stroke. Functionally silent by reducing blood flow, remains metabolically active. Cells in this area are endangered but not yet irreversibly damaged. That means cells are not irreversibly damaged, they are reversibly damaged. They may undergo apoptosis. So you know we discussed apoptosis, programmed cell death. So apoptosis after several hours or days, but if blood flow and oxygen delivery is restored shortly after the onset of stroke, they are potentially recoverable. So we can recover these strokes since the cells will be there in the apoptosis stage. It may be for hours or it may be for many days also. So when the oxygen recovery is done, then the stroke get cured and persons becomes normal state. Then pathophysiology or pathogenesis of hemorrhagic stroke. Hemorrhagic strokes are due to the rupture of blood vessels leading to compression of brain tissue from an expanding hematoma. So here expanding hematoma is there. Due to that compression, the brain tissue is happening, blood vessels rupture, hemorrhage happens and causes the stroke. This can distort and injure tissues. In addition, the pressure may lead to a loss of blood supply to affected tissue with resulting infraction, and the blood released by brain hemorrhage appears to have direct toxic effects on brain tissue and vasculature. So this hemorrhagic stroke is very dangerous since bleeding happens, though bleeding will cause the nerves damage. That again, two types: intracerebral hemorrhage, subarachnoid hemorrhage. First one, intracerebral hemorrhage, caused by rupture of blood vessels and accumulation of blood within the brain. This is commonly the result of blood vessel damage from chronic hypertension, vascular malformations, or the use medications associated with increased bleeding rates, such as anticoagulants, thrombolytics, and antiplatelet agents. So if any person is taking anticoagulant medicines and thrombolytic medicines and antiplatelet major agents, then they are highly susceptible to intracerebral hemorrhage, in which bleeding happens in the brain, inside the brain. Then subarachnoid hemorrhage, it is the gradual collection of blood in the subarachnoid space of the brain, dura, typically caused by trauma to the head or rupture of a cerebral aneurysm. So here maybe accident to the head or rupture of cerebral aneurysm, subarachnoid space bleeding happens, that is subarachnoid hemorrhage. So here intracerebral hemorrhage and subarachnoid hemorrhage may cause hemorrhagic stroke. Then next, early warning signs of stroke. So these are the symptoms of the stroke which appear early. Sudden numbness or weakness of face, arm or leg, especially on one side of the body. So one side of the body, arm or leg or face becomes numbness or weakness. Sudden confusion, troubling speaking or understanding. Then third one is sudden trouble seeing in one or both eyes. Number 4 point, sudden trouble walking, dizziness, loss of balance or coordination. So these are the major symptoms of the early signs of stroke. Other important but less common symptoms: sudden nausea, fever and vomiting, distinguished from a viral illness by the speed of onset. So due to sudden nausea, fever, vomiting may happen. Brief loss of consciousness or rapid period of decreased consciousness. So here loss of consciousness may happen in stroke, or decreased consciousness for a certain period may happen in the stroke. Next, transient ischemic attack, TIA. It refers to temporary interruption of blood supply to the brain. So temporary interruption of blood supply to the brain. Symptoms may last for only few minutes or for several hours, but does not last for longer than 24 hours. So TIA is always less than 24 hours. Blood supply decreases less than 24 hours time. After the attack is over, there is no evidence of residual brain damage or permanent neurological dysfunction. So there is no permanent neurological dysfunction is observed. Neurological complications and associated conditions with stroke. These are the neurological conditions associated with stroke: altered consciousness, disorders of speech and language, dysphagia, that means phagia means eating. Dysphagia means the person is not having the eating habit. Cognitive dysfunction, so memory dysfunction, altered emotional status, perceptual dysfunction, seizures, bladder and bowel dysfunction, cardiovascular and pulmonary dysfunction, deep venous thrombosis and pulmonary embolus, osteoporosis and fracture risk. In bracket you can see physical rehabilitation. So by the physical rehabilitation, stroke can be cured, but it will take a certain period of time based on the patient's severity. Then you can see it down. Know the signs of a stroke. When it comes to the stroke care, time is of the essence. Remember, B first, B-E-F-A-S-T, B first. So B means balance, E means eyes, F means face, A means arm, S means speech, T means time. So B, balance. Sudden loss of balance is the first symptom. Eyes, sudden loss of vision in one or both eyes. Then F, uneven face, facial droop or uneven smile. So person's face, left or right side of the face, we can see some bending, drooping. Then arm, sudden armless weakness, that means we can't lift at a time two arms above the head region. So that is the sudden arm weakness. Speech, sudden slurred speech or trouble speaking, confusion. Time is critical. Call 911 immediately and get admitted in the hospital. So this is how the, you can see the eye problem, eye vision gets suppressed, balance of the body gets suppressed, face droop, arm weakness, speech. Then stroke, sequential recovery stages of stroke, up to 6th stage recovery, stage 1. In stage 1, what happens? This, in the case of recovery, occurs in a stereotyped sequence of events that begins with a period of flaccidity immediately following acute episode. No movement of limbs can be elicited. So in the first stage of the stroke recovery, no movement of the limbs will be seen. Stage 2, spasticity begins to develop. So muscle spasm starts in the stage 2, voluntary muscles. Stage 3, gains voluntary control of movement, synergy, although full range is not developed, spasticity has further increased. So muscle spasms, skeletal muscle spasms is increasing. So they are having a certain movement of the muscles can be seen. Stage 4, spasticity began to decline. So spasticity decreases. Some movement combination that do not follow the synergy are mastered first with difficulty and later with more ease. So person will be moving individually without help of others. Stage 5, More difficult movement are learnt as the basic limb synergy lose their dominance over motor roots. So basic limb synergy, so they are moving, more difficult movement can be seen. Stage 6, disappearance of spasticity. Individual joint movement become possible and coordination approaches normal. So body brain coordination increases and individual joint movement can be seen in the stage 6. Normal motor function is restored. So it is taking 6 stage cure of the stroke. They will do physiotherapy to restore the person's body nervous system function by supplying the oxygen blood supply to the brain. So you can see stroke, we can compare thrombotic stroke and embolic strokes in diagram. Thrombus plug is there, atherosclerotic plug is there, whereas embolic stroke there is no atherosclerotic plug. But clot is there, red blood cells is there, everything is same. Thrombotic stroke and embolic stroke means atherosclerotic plug is there in thrombotic stroke, whereas no atherosclerotic plug in the embolic stroke. Then hemorrhagic stroke, bleeding of the blood will be seen. Then you can see here, stroke, face drooping, A, arm weakness, S, speech difficulty, T, time to call, fast, B, fast. Then next, the following points should be given special consideration while assessing a stroke patient. Stroke patient we are assessing means we should give severity of the stroke assessed in a person by these factors. Higher function examination, that means person is having memory or intelligence, intellectual quotient, they will check. So memory and intelligence they will check, higher functional examination. Cranial nerves examination, 12 cranial nerves examination will be done. Then motor examination, movement examination, body movement examination. Reflex testing, sudden spinal cord reflex by emotions, they are going to check. Coordination testing, all sense organs coordination they will check. Sensory evaluation, smell, touch, pain, taste, sound, vision evaluation. Flexibility and joint integrity, postural control and balance, body posture is in control or not, they can move or not, that will they will check. Gait and locomotion evaluation, body balance, gait is nothing but body balance, locomotion movement evaluation. Jogging, they can do jogging or not, they can't walk with his two legs in a proper balanced body. Integumentary integrity, joints and skin or integumentary organs, they will check. Aerobic capacity and endurance, aerobic means oxygen supply, blood and respiration capacity, endurance, they will check. Functional status, FIM and Barthal index. So this Barthal index, FIM, the functional status of a person will be judged. So Barthal index BI, if you see, Barthal index BI is an ordinal scale used to measure performance in activities of daily living. So person, how actively he is living, person they will check by the Barthal index. The Barthal index includes 10 personal activities they will check and they will give the scoring. 10 activities means feeding, that means eating, drinking, personal toileting, bathing, dressing and undressing, getting on and off of a toilet, controlling bladder, controlling bowel, movement from wheelchair to bed and returning, walking on level surface or propelling a wheelchair if unable to walk, ascending and descending stairs. So these are the 10 different personal activities they will check the person is possible to do or not. That will show his daily living, how much actively he is living. The original index is a 3-item ordinal rating scale completed by a therapist or other observer in 2 to 5 minutes. Each item is rated in terms of whether the patient can perform the task independently with some assistance or is dependent on help based on observation. 0 is equal to unable, 0 point means unable, 1 means needs help, 2 means independent. The final score is multiplied by 5 to get a number on a 100 point score. 100 score, how much he is going to score, they will do by multiplying with 5. Proposed guidelines for interpreting Barthal scores are that scores of 0 to 20 if you get, the tot person is total dependent on the others. 21 to 60 indicate severe dependency. So 0 to 20 means totally dependent, 21 to 60 severe dependency, 61 to 90 indicates moderate dependency. The person who is the stroked person is moderately depending on the others. 91 to 99 indicates slight dependency. Most studies apply the 60/61 cutting point. So that means the person should score minimum 60 points, then the person is able to walk and he is recovering from the stroke. The next Barthel scale index, you can see number 1 bowel movements, 0, 1, 2 points given. So 0 means inconsistent, needs to be given enema, bowel movement for that they should give enema. 1 means occasional accident once per week, 2 means continent. So that means these points, if he get more points, the person physically fit. If he is less point, he is physically not fit. So bowel movements, bowel means stomach movements, intestinal movements. Then bladder. So bladder 0, 1, 2, you can see urinary bladder. Inconsistent or catheterization, unable to manage. So he can't manage urination means 0 point. Number 1 means he is having some accident, occasional accident. 2 means consistent for over 7 days, he is no problem in urination, then 2 points. Then grooming, needs help with personal care, independent face, bar, hair, teeth, shaving, implements provided. So here shaving, teeth, whatever the brushing, hair cleaning, so these all these grooming. Then toilet use, if he is using independently then 2 points, he needs some help means 1 point, he is dependent on others means 0 point. Feeding, eating, cutting, okay, so all this comes under feeding. Then transfer from one place to other place, he is unable to sit or he can walk, that is a transfer. Then mobility, movement, immobile means 0 point, wheelchair dependent means 1 point, and walking with help of one person means 2 point, independent walking means 3 point. Then 8, dressing, 0 dependent, 1 means needs help, 2 means independent dressing, buttons, zips and laces he can put easily dressing. Then 9, stairs, so stay upstairs, downstairs he can walk. 0, unable to walk, 1 means needs help, 2 means independent up and down. So 10 means bathing, 0 dependent, 1 independent. So this whatever the 10 parameters is there, so in these 10 parameters mentioned, if the person is getting more than 60 points, then the person is physically fit and he can walk slowly and he can get easily cured from the stroke. If he is getting less than 50 points, then the person is highly suffering with the stroke and his brain is not properly working. So that person should be given the treatment, medicines treatment as well as physical therapy, physiotherapy treatment they should give for a certain period to cure the stroke persons, to regain the normal cerebral function by supplying the blood to the brain. Thank you.